Hello everyone, it's Danny. Okay, today we're gonna answer a question sent in by one of my viewers, and this is regarding algae. Why are algae forming in my orchid pot? Is it a sign? Is it a good sign? Is it a bad sign? Do they affect the orchid in any way? Alrighty, so let's discuss a little bit about algae. Okay, you have to know something about the wonderful little algae. They're the first chlorophytic form of life on Earth. They have been around for quite a lot of years. And for this reason, they have adapted very, very well. They're more resilient than plants, any plants, aquatic plants, terrestrial plants, whatever you name it. So algae and algae spores and everything are practically everywhere. You cannot really block their access into your orchid pots and any other pot you might have because they're simply everywhere. Even in your tap water, in some cases. So first off, you cannot really avoid having them. The good news is, they're not actually damaging your orchid in any way, especially if they're in small numbers like you see here. They're not gonna kill your orchid, though some might debate that they can compete with the orchid to get nutrients, because algae, like other plants, feed on nitrogen and other elements. Again, if they're in small numbers like this, I don't think you should worry about algae depleting your orchid of nutrients. However, even if they're not harmful to the orchid, they can signify something very bad happening in your orchid pot. In order for algae to thrive, they actually need three things. One is light. The other is moisture, and the third is nutrients. Now, nutrients are practically inevitable because we do feed our orchids. Also, the bark starts to decompose and it will start producing nitrogen in a form or another, which algae can feed upon. But in regards with the other two aspects, they might signify that your orchid pot is staying way too moist for the benefit of your orchid. So if you're dealing with an orchid which really likes to dry out very fast and very well between waterings, let's say a Calea orchid or a Phalaenopsis orchid, the appearance of algae might signify you are watering too frequent. It can also signify that the media is breaking down and is retaining more moisture than it should. So in that respect, the appearance of algae might mean you need to repot your orchid because of the broken down media, or that you actually need to water less frequent and also provide more ventilation in the orchid pot. So if you think about it, they can actually tell you if the media in your orchid pot is suitable for the orchid, or if your moisture level is not appropriate for the particular variety or species of orchid you're growing. Now, if you're wondering how to prevent the appearance of algae in an orchid pot, it's quite simple. All you need to do is cut the light source. Let's say you're dealing with an orchid which actually do prefers to stay more moist than dry, let's say a Miltoniopsis or an Oncidium orchid, can actually use a decorative pot around the orchid pot. This way, light will not come through and promote algae growth. Also, you can provide ventilation holes, especially if you're dealing with an orchid which likes to dry out between waterings. This will also save you from root rot in most cases and has the benefit to actually limit algae propagation and growth. As for the example that I'm showing you today, I know very well why I have some algae growing. If you notice, they don't necessarily go higher than this level. You remember last summer that I was gone and I was forced to leave my orchids in a little tray of water, a little higher tray, let's call it. Well, because of the humidity and the light the orchid received, the algae formed. They had an appropriate environment, so they formed. They don't actually affect the orchid in any way. The orchid grows healthy and everything is okay. But they just signaled to me that the media stayed way too moist for my own good. But alas, I was forced to do so. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video and answered a few questions. At some point or another, I think it's practically impossible to avoid a few algae formation, especially in the pots that do require to stay more moist than dry. But usually the algae don't really affect the orchid. We do provide fertilizer regularly, so I don't think they actually deplete the orchid of the nutrients. So if you have other questions or suggestions for videos, just leave me a comment and I'll try to make a video for you guys. And also, if you like my videos, don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you next time. Bye!